What is going on, guys? Mr. Bazy here, and today we're going to be doing, you guessed it, some more Seduce Me. Otherwise, it would be kind of misleading if you clicked on it and it wasn't Seduce Me. But we're doing some more Seduce Me. I'm really excited about getting back to this. Thank you for being patient. There was some other stuff. I was actually sick for a little while, and I feel like every time I come back, I kind of have to give you guys, it feels like excuses, but, you know, obviously I'm not going to lie. That's really what happened. But, you know, I do feel bad that sometimes there are gaps. I'm trying my hardest not to, and I'm trying to keep up with everything. So again, hopefully you can excuse that. But in any case, really quick, before we get started, two things. I'm going to make it quick. Don't worry. The giveaway and Pokemon. Let's start with Pokemon. Pokemon, I did create my second episode just yesterday. I'm pretty sure this video is going up the day after. So I did create it just yesterday. Hopefully you guys enjoy that. I'll leave a link right here for you to enjoy. And it will also be the little pop-out eye for you. And anything that is linked in this video, whether it's annotations on the video, like the Pokemon Go thing, or the outro stuff, will be in the little eye, so you guys on mobile can access it easily without having to worry about anything. So that's how that's going to work. Check it out if you're interested in Pokemon. I personally think I did a much better job on the second video, and it was much more entertaining. So if you're interested at all, it's right up there. In pertinence to the giveaway, today we will be doing the giveaway, so it will happen at a random time during the course of the video, whether today we finish Sam's route or not. I was intending to do it last video, but I did not, I actually forgot about it, or not forgot, but I wasn't thinking. I was like, you know what, actually next episode's probably going to be the end of the game, and so I wasn't really thinking properly about it. But today is going to be the giveaway, regardless of whether or not we finish today or not, and then hopefully later in other playthroughs we'll be doing those giveaways at random intervals, so it's not going to always happen at the end, unless you guys want to see it at the end every single time. Let me know in the comments if that's something you want. But in any case, obviously we're starting it out, as you can see, with a very spicy scene. You know we're clicking on Make Love to Sam. I mean, come on, that's what we've vowed to do from the demo. Like I said, you know, no matter what, we're always going to choose the spicy option. A wave of carnal need rushed through me, needing to indulge all that I could tonight. It was stupid to believe that tomorrow could have been our last day alive, but reality scared me. And so the natural reaction is to bone. I was scared and I needed to release that fear in Sam's arms. I was going to say, he might be releasing it somewhere else. I'm just saying, we need to rock as if the world was ending. We needed to rock as if the world was ending because we didn't know if it would. I gripped onto Sam's jacket and pulled him close to me, slamming my lip. Damn, girl, chill. You're going to break his face into his and feeling him gasp against our kiss. He stared wide-eyed at me for a moment before gripping to my waist hard and returning my kiss. He was feeling the same. I could feel the tremors of his own concern rubble beneath his fingertips as they gently dragged themselves along my waist and buried themselves under my clothes. I was going to say, the tremble you might be feeling, I doubt is from his fingertips, unless he's got multiple wean pieces or something. I pulled away slightly, panting as I burned my gaze into his eyes. That'd be really, I mean, depending on your viewpoint, that's either hot or gross. In my viewpoint, it's kind of gross. Elmaurice. His eyes flashed a gold color at the sound of his true name. I would use it and call it over and over to make him drive me to the blissful night we desperately needed. His grip on me tightened as I leaned in nose to nose, repeating it in a husky tone. Ew, a husky tone? Gross. Like Emery. I doubt she really needs to... Emery. I doubt she really needs to, you know, coax him into this. I mean, he is an incubus after all. A carnal snarl escaped Sam's lips before he roughly cupped a hand behind my head and pulled me into a hard kiss, growling lustfully against my lips as I groaned at the feeling. The gates of our control flung open, and we let it all in. It almost became too easy tearing Sam's clothes off of his body. Damn, it was definitely easy for him to strip every last article off of my body and take in the sensation of our skin-to-skin contact. The heat dancing over our skins became almost unbearable. What? As he marched me to bed and pinned me down, biting over my lip. Why does every guy sound like they're about to eat her? Like straight up, like literally, not in the fun way, okay? In the actual like feasting kind of I'm hungry as shit way, like you're about to die way. Biting over my lip before planting. Before I was like planting nips, you just grow them. I would bear the love bites and hickeys he was painting over my skin with pride. All I cared about was feeling him within my arms and screaming his name as we finally passed the point of no return. His demon needs spurred him on, skyrocketing the passion between us as I let it fall from my mouth between my euphoric cries of pleasure. His fingers clawed over my back as my own gripped his shoulders hard, returning the favor. These dudes are going to end up like bloody after the end of this. This is gross, man. They're going to be all torn to ribbons. My name fell from his own lips between his hard and loving kisses over my neck and shoulder. As he finally claimed my lips to silence us both, we became unhinged and soared through multiple peaks of ecstasy. Damn. Okay then. You guys are getting no sleep apparently. I could barely remember how many we rushed through, but our emotions were running high, and the beautiful afterglow that awaited us gave us a soft descent into a blissful haze in each other's arms. He's okay, that's ridiculous. We both were hurting, aching from the amount of energy released in our lovemaking. That's a key indicator to stop. Like, when it stops feeling good, you stop. Like, you don't keep going. But thankful in the end that we did. We didn't even need to speak as we held each other close and let the night consume us. My heart was filled of Sam. Again, not healthy. And I became slowly protective of my love for him. If tomorrow was going to be a test against death, then it was a test I would succeed in. I would not let the Demon Lord or anyone take Sam away from me again.
I love you, Amaryse.
Tomorrow would decide everything. I'm going to go ahead and not skip. I mean, I'm going to show you guys all the parts that are actually even remotely different. But anything that is actually 100% similar, I will include in, you know, the video. So here we go. We'll see what ends up getting put in here, because I'm assuming a large majority is going to be similar. All right. So I believe this is different. I mean, I'll include it if it is. But I'm pretty sure this is a different, like, kind of strategy. We talked about going through the side route, how Diana is going to dominate the Demon Lord, all that stuff. So now Shadow is proposing apparently a different strategy, so we're going to check it out. Shadow turned and pointed to the map, his finger pressed against a tower structure on the Demon Lord's castle.
If my scouts are correct, then that tower directly hovers over the decaying sea.
The what? Shadow turned to me with an unamused grimace. How am I supposed to know? The Decaying Sea. I know that place. That's where I went to go have a picnic, dude. While Rabbit stepped towards me, hugging her staff to her body.
Decaying Sea. A cursed stretch of water that has plagued this side of the demon world for thousands of years. Many demons have fallen into that water and were never seen again. It's no ordinary sea. It's an eternal death wish.
This dude's like, I know, dude, I dipped my toe in it, and it's just gone. just from the look in Rabbit's eyes, I could tell that this sea was bad news. She had lost her tail in it, a few years back. Shadow nodded at Rabbit's description, adding more to the fright of the waters the castle was pressed against. That's not good.
Any creature unfortunate enough to fall into that cursed stretch of water will be doomed to sink into an endless black void. They can never die due to the dark magic in the water, but they can never come back up. There's no saving them.
So they just drown over and over? Or they just... Wait, what? But they can't breathe, so I'm assuming they're in just constant distress. Jeez, man. There's no saving them? You can't just, like, lower a rope down and hope someone grabs it? Jeez. I became fearful just thinking about going near it. However, Diana crossed her arms and stared blankly at Shadow.
So you wish for me to drag him up to the tower and toss him over?
Precisely. It would make killing him much easier, wouldn't you think?
You just said he wouldn't die. I mean, he would never be able to... I mean, that's not a permanent solution. Why can't you just cross him off like you did with the... You know, in the previous playthrough. Diana pressed her lips together, not agreeing or disagreeing with the suggestion given to her. However, the conversation quickly turned back to the matter at hand. The remaining incubi and the wives were asked to stay behind the army and guard the main base, where Rabbit and Faye were stationed. They needed as many eyes as possible in the back of the battle, so the four couples were perfect to keep things in check. Gross.
To war! To-
Shh. I'm concentrating.
Make sure you stay safe.
Dude, legitimately like her fourth line. I'm just saying. I hope she has more lines in the future, because we like know really nothing about... I mean, wait, this sucks. We saw that sweet moment with Sam's wife back when we were on James playthrough. We saw Damien. We saw everyone's wives. And now, you know, we don't really... I kind of feel like I'm lacking content with her. You know what I mean? So maybe in the future. Maybe in the future.
Princess.
Oh, and this. And this.
We'll see you in the end.
What the fuck? I can't even do that shit.
We'll finish this.
Make sure you kick some serious ass.
You kick some ass too with those kitten leggings, girl. I'm gonna hound you for that the whole time. Matthew, I mean, I'll give you that, Matthew. She looks kind of cute with those things, but... I mean, seriously, this dude don't have pants. Everyone's ready for battle except you guys. Like, he's ready to go. Okay, pantsless. That's like straight beast status. I mean, I'm just saying, man. This dude's sitting there like he's playing Pokemon Go with his hand in his pocket so he don't get mugged or something. She's just like, I don't know what's going on, but I like my kitten leggings. And he's like, dude, I'm just going to sit here with my nub. Really quick, again, I'm going to include everything. You guys know you've seen the previous playthrough, and I'm assuming you guys kind of know what happens. I'm trying to summarize here as we go along to skip all the stuff that we've already seen. So obviously, little, motivational speeches, whatnot. And now we're in the forest heading to the castle. And I forgot. I was ready to skip through this, but we have new weapons, so I'm going to read this and see if it's any different. I walk forward and form my weapon, letting it shine brightly in the darkness of the forest around us and temporarily blinding the imps ahead of us. My hands form the katars I had trained with, feeling their weight in my hands as the blade glimmered a lavender glow of energy. I swung my hands a bit, recalling the reach and balance of the weapons in my hands as I prepared to attack. The imps, who were blinded by my light only for a moment, looked back at me and stared as they took note of the weapon I had possessed. With a battle cry, I rushed forward, taking advantage of their blank state. Ah! I arched my body to the side and jabbed forward, running my blade through the face of an imp before slicing through it and spinning around to slash through the imp beside him, opening two large gashes in his chest through his ribs and lungs. Damn, this is like... This is detailed. We're literally talking about, like, freaking anatomy class here. Jesus. Oh, poor imp. There was no noises in the previous one. The imps fell as the others became shell-shocked at the sight. It must have been a big surprise to see a human cut down two of their number, but I wasn't in the mood to let them recover. My body quickly turned in front of another imp as I swung my weapon once again, slicing open his throat. With a bubbly cry, he fell as well, as I rushed forward again towards the castle, uncaring. Uncaring? What? We're literally back at the castle eating crackers and cheese all innocent, and now we're just like uncaring. We're like soaked in like imp blood. Jeez, man. Holy crap, she's got a beast inside of her. Damn. The remaining imps began to quake and step back in fear, most likely never expecting to see a human decimate their companions. I wasn't so friendly and merciful, especially in this war, as I lunged forward again and skewered through another imp. She put her arm through this dude, straight up, hearing the steel of my weapon breaking through his body. My incubus, despite probably being surprised at my carnage, followed as I continued forward, fighting through every imp that came in our way. I had lost count of how many crossed me, but I didn't care. She's freaking ruthless. She's a savage at this point. Damn. All I cared about was getting to the castle. Well, we're there, and now we're skipping, because that was worth stopping to read, because holy crap. Whoa, okay, so this is different, okay? So it says, with that, Sam and I raced forward. The final battle had begun. At the gates, however, stood a figure that seemed to pose almost pridefully in our path. This is different. And also, going to be interesting to see how all this pans out, because at this point, we were worried about the angels, right? And the angel was, well, we didn't know it yet, but the angel was possessing Diana. So this is going to be a bit different. Sam and I stopped our run and took in who was standing in our way. For some reason, he seemed familiar. Who? Oh my god, I was wondering what happened to him, dude. I was wondering what happened to Malix, bro. Holy shit. Didn't you get scrubbed on in the previous friggin' game? That voice. You're on the Demon Lord's side, are you stoopy? My mind finally clicked, linking the voice to a memory I wish I had forgotten. However, it couldn't have been. No way. Holy shit! Are you good? You don't look good, you have an extra horn. Someone's been experimenting. Sam began to growl almost animalistically as the figure stepped out of the shadow of the gate. His face was covered by a terrifying devil mask, but I recognized him despite the fact. His white hair, his red skin. There was no way it could have been.
Missed me, bitch?
Oh, shit.
Malix.
At the sound of his name, Malix reached up and removed the mask from his face. Oh my god, bro. You look a lot different. Revealing a large amount of scars and wounds that were hidden away. Despite this, there was also a smirk plastered from ear to ear across Malix's cheeks.
You're supposed to be dead!
You didn't think I actually died, did you? Only pussy little boys like you can get taken out like that.
Fantastic. My heart froze at the fact that he was still alive. It couldn't have been. I had seen what had happened to him. He was... I didn't see that. I mean, I'm kind of upset that I missed it now, because if that happened to him, the last thing I remember is he got into a conflict with his girlfriend, and she tossed him into some hell or something. I don't know. She just scrubbed him up. That's the last thing I remember. But he was supposed to be dead, apparently. Jeez. Malik inhaled a deep breath and stretched out his arms, looking around with the largest grin on his face before turning to Sam.
Isn't this the most brutal war you've ever seen? Legions killing each other for no goddamn reason other than to rule this pathetic plane. It makes me want to make popcorn and watch the bloodshed.
Then why don't you do that, bro? Get out of the way. Sam glared hard at Malik, taking a step towards him. Malik, however, cackled in response and locked eyes with the incubus.
Of course. I came here for a reason. I can't just sit on my ass and watch. Too bad, though. This is some great entertainment.
And why are you here, asswipe? Got a real death wish this time?
What makes you think you can kill me? Besides, aren't you trying to save energy to fight your old man?
Oh, we're gonna have to fight him. Oh, this is gonna be ridiculous. I mean, we were already kind of scrubbing him up with our magic in the first game. Now we have, I'm assuming magic and these freaking Qatar things. Oh, it's gonna be on fire. But you know what I wanna, point out here is, I don't know why. I don't know if you guys are getting this vibe, but the music, and for some reason the way he's dressed and all that stuff, for some reason this is reminding me like a Naruto fight. I don't know why, but it just feels like it to me. But in any case, I hope we get to fight him, because it's gonna be pretty awesome. And I hope that we get little action choices, like we were when we were training with Diana and Sarah and stuff. Malik stuffed his hands into his pockets and leaned back, puffing his chest out and flaunting the burnt insignia on his chest.
I got sent here by the head of hell himself, straight from the top, and I got the best seats in the house to the bloodiest war this plane has ever seen.
Why would he do that? Like, what is the benefit of that? Sam chuckled, cracking his knuckles.
Funny. I thought Satan only gave a shit about devils who didn't get their faces beaten in. Seems like he's getting soft.
Oh, shit. Instantly, Malik's face shifted to an angry scowl, making the smirk on Sam's face widen. Well, why are you proud to have that? I mean, I guess he's a devil, but see, either way, first of all, it looks painful as anything.
Now that you're all hot and bothered, wanna tell me what you're up to before I send you back with your head up your ass?
That sounds extremely difficult.
First, I'm gonna paint these gates with your blood. Then wait until this war is over before I annihilate every fucking demon left and make this world a part of hell, just like it was supposed to be.
Well then, damn, that's an ambitious goal.
You're funny for a dead man.
Am I? You tried to kill me once before, dipshit, and look where that got you. Didn't work out so well, did it?
But I'm assuming based on your appearance, you lost. So whether he killed you or not, you still got scrubbed on. Malik stretched his neck to the side, making a loud, echoey crack sound reverberate through the air. I winced at the sound. That's what happens when I crack my neck. People are like, damn, that's loud.
What makes this so funny is that it won't matter who wins this war in the end. Once it's over, I'll send for my boys and we'll fuck everyone up while they're celebrating. Ha! It'll be the bloodiest celebration this plane has ever seen!
Jeez.
Then we'll seal this world and fuse it with hell, giving Satan a whole world full of demon soldiers and slaves at his disposal. The chaos of this world practically begged for a war to tear it apart. Now the Abyssal Plains will truly be a part of hell, like the fuck faces of heaven intended.
What?
Not if I make sure you don't get the chance, fucker.
Damn, there's some language being used in this set of dialogue. Malik cackled wildly, staring at Sam with a maddening expression, his eyes burned with insane bloodlust as he smirked and licked his teeth. Gross.
It's this world's destiny, shithead! Even humans know that demons belong in hell.
Oh my. No, they don't. Lisa, come on. Really? Like, you're just gonna butt in now? I felt myself, if she had not met Sam, I guarantee her freaking answer would be a bit different. I felt myself become angrier at Malik's. Demons and devils were completely different. And demons, except for the demon lord, did not belong anywhere near hell. Okay. Oh my god.
Well, yeah. How many brainless humans think that demons come from hell? They put demons and devils together like they're no different from each other. It's inevitable. Every shit stain on this world is gonna bow down to the Lord of Hell, and we'll rip apart the gates of heaven together.
Well, someone needs to stop that shit. Sam stepped forward once more, cracking his knuckles at his sides.
I am so sick of hearing your voice, Malix. Let's just end this.
No, dude, we gotta fight. I feel like if we fight, though, we're gonna get crossed off. I always feel like any decision I make will get me crossed off.
Oh, I almost forgot the best part.
Malix locked eyes with me, suddenly making a violent tremor run down my spine. His gaze spoke nothing but sadistic intent, and his words made his stare much more terrifying.
Just because I can, after we're done taking over this world, I'm gonna take that human bitch and make her the fucktoy of Zayden's army.
We need to run! Like, right? I mean, no, we got this. We're gonna kick his butt. But that's a scary thought, man. Oh shit, I'm assuming Sam did some crazy stuff. Instantly, Sam vanished and he's Goku! And reappeared in front of Malix, swinging a punch at him. However, he only made contact with a vanishing after image. Oh no. This is literally the fight between Goku and... Who the hell is ugly? Cell? Yeah, Cell. Before I could blink, Malix had disappeared and reappeared behind Sam, punching Sam's head and sending him flying toward the castle wall. We can't fight that! I was thinking we would have this. Sam!
Payback time, fuckface!
Oh, jeez. Malix flew at Sam's body like a bullet and began to slam his fist into him, the wall cracking and caving in around Sam's body. Use your dragon shit, man! You need to do something. Oh, shit. We gotta save. We gotta save, dudes. Because I'm thinking to myself, right, you know, I'm thinking in the previous playthroughs, you know, Diana killed the Demon Lord by herself. She didn't need the help of the person we were with at the time. And then the only reason that James, which was the person we were with, got into an altercation was because of the angel after that. There's no angel we have to worry about here. So I'm thinking to myself, is Diana going to beat the Demon Lord again? I'm assuming he will. You know... I don't know, dude. Like, is he going to beat the Demon Lord again? Or is she going to beat the Demon Lord again? And will we have to do nothing? Like, can he expend his energy here? I'm assuming they're going to give me more than just one choice here, okay? I'm assuming they're going to give me more than one choice. Or one chance to help. So we'll see if Sam can turn this around, because he hasn't used his new drag. He's a Dragonborn. So let's just see if he can pull something out of his ass. Let's stay back. A part of me knew better than to try. Malix probably had a weapon, and if I knew anything about Malix, he would use that against me without hesitation. I was out of energy to even defend myself from him, and I was sure that's why my grandfather's protection spell ran on. He wanted to beat Sam before trying to kill him. His pride was one downfall of his that I remembered very clearly. Malix continued to pound punch upon punch into Sam's body, making the body-shaped indentation in the castle wall that much deeper. However, with a small flash of red light, heat suddenly began to erupt from the center.
Get
off! Oh, shit. Malix was suddenly forced back from a bright energy pulse as Sam pushed himself out of the hole he was trapped in. Around his body were green flickering waves of energy pulsating in time with Sam's breath. Is he's gonna use dragon breath? Freaking like a Pokemon? I stared in shock, watching smoke rise from the creases of Sam's mouth. He is, dude. And his nostrils as he formed a large sword in his hands. Something in his eyes was burning and he fueled it with rage.
Ooh, got some fire this time, huh?
Jeez. Malix raised the arm at his side, forming a large sword with a red blade and a chain connecting from the hilt to his belt.
Well, so do I.
Oh no. Malix and Sam rushed at each other, slamming their swords into each other with reckless speed. I couldn't understand how Malix gained the ability to be as fast as Sam, but something about the devil was very different from the first and last time I had seen him. He was much more cocky and there was some sort of strength within him that frightened me more than before. However, I felt that Sam still had the upper hand. There was no way he would let Malix win. Sam flipped over Malix and slashed his back, opening the fabric of his vest, but not deep enough to make contact with his skin. Malix snarled and spun around, reinitiating their clash of swords.
What's wrong, pretty boy? You seem to be holding back!
Oh no.
I don't need to waste energy killing you!
Oh shit. At last, their swords slammed against one another, a screech echoing through the air. Both pushed against one another, snarling into each other's faces.
It's pointless, Incubus! This world is fucked!
Tell that to Satan when you die!
Oh, dang. Sam suddenly lifted his foot up and jammed it into Malix's chest, kicking him back towards the castle wall. With a grunt and the crack of broken ribs reverberating through the air, Malix slid back and glared at Sam. However, the glare quickly died into a look of sadistic amusement as Malik rolled his shoulders and stood back up, as if he could just shrug off the injury. Around his body grew a bright orange and red flame, causing waves of heat to pulse through the air around us.
Final showdown?
Oh my god.
You got it!
Dude, this is a Dragon Ball Z fight right now, seriously. Sam, with a smirk of his own, stood tall with a fast-growing green and red aura surrounding his form. The faint outline of dragons danced within the tongues of the flames as Sam seemed to charge a powerful attack. Dude.
It's over, Malik.
I watched as they both charged up their final attacks and forced their palms out towards each other. Green and red orbs of light shot out from each of their hands and collided, followed by brilliant rays that pushed them forward and into each other. I had to shut my eyes, blocking the flash of light from blinding my vision, before looking back up and seeing the bout with a gas. What's the bout? The air around the orbs pulsed heavily, whipping in all directions and fueled by both the demon and the devil. The orbs ground into one another, lightning and fire bursting from the minuscule space between them. Both opponents had their eyes locked on each other as the earth around them bent and bowed away from the collision of their power. Dude. The green orb seemed to quake with the shadows of dragons in its center, pressing it against the wall of the orb and forcing it forward against its obstacle. Still, they were somehow equally matched. How could this be?
Give in your remaining energy, child. It's the only way to end.
The remaining? Like, death? The voice of the dragon rang in my head as I stared at Sam. His face was tightened in pure anger and determination. He was giving as much as he could, but I knew he was holding back to save energy for his father. I took a breath and quickly rushed over to Sam, grabbing hold of his arm and feeling his body naturally pull energy from me.
What are you doing?
Helping. Ending this together. Sam stared at me, causing his orb to falter. But as I passed my energy on to him, Sam nodded and focused back on Malik, concentrating his orb forward with both his energy and mine. Malik would not win. I wouldn't let him. Dude. We're still bossing it. At last, the deadlock became pressed as Sam's orb pushed Malik's back inch by inch. With each push getting stronger and faster, I could feel myself growing dizzy, but I didn't care. This was Malik's last stand.
What? No!
I glared hard at Malik as the clash between them became full of green energy, cutting through the devil's attack with ease. At last, the dragons reached their prey as the orb finally clashed into Malik's body, enveloping him in light. Oh, are you getting crossed off? I do believe so. Say, he's dust. Sam and I held on to each other, letting go of the energy ray and covering our eyes, with Sam covering me with his arm. We dug our heels into the earth, struggling to stay in place as energy pushed us away from Malik. Whoa, dude, the gusts pressed and rushed against our bodies until at last the wind stopped. Sam and I slowly lifted our heads and looked over, wanting to see what had become of Malik. There was no trace of him. The spot where he stood was charred, and the smoke that rose from the ashes of the area danced in the air like rising dragons. We did it. We killed him at last. Don't say that, he's gonna come back. I crumpled to my knees, slamming my hands to the ground to keep myself upright as I panted. I was worn out. If I had been out of energy before, I definitely was now. Sam quickly dropped down beside me, wrapping an arm around my shoulders and laying a careful hand on my arm.
Whoa! Are you okay?
Oh, shit. I nodded, obviously lying. what benefit does that freaking do, man? But I knew that we had more important things to worry about. Malik was gone, hopefully dead for real, and we were at the castle gates, ready to charge in and fight the Demon Lord. As Sam and I looked up, we both locked our sights on a window exploding outward with a figure flying out of it. No, Diana lost. As the figure flapped their wings and steadied themselves, they swooped back inside. Never mind. Diana! I gripped Sam's arm and lifted myself up, knowing that we had to get inside.
Good.
Yeah, let's just go. Alright guys, so here we are on the giveaway, okay? I know it's a little bit of an abrupt intermission because I didn't announce it, but I did decide I'm not going to do it during the video, I'll do it afterwards, which is what this is. Because I wanted to make sure I got in every single person that was, you know, that wanted to get in. Because there were a few last minute entries, so I wanted to make sure I got them too. It's only fair, there's only 5 or 6 codes, so that's why, you know, and I'm doing it after the video. Now, I know I always say 5 to 6 codes. The reason I say that is because there are 5 guaranteed codes that I was given for, you know, each male incubus. And I'm planning on using my code if possible. I have to make sure that that'll work. For the sixth playthrough, which is going to be Diana or whoever it ends up being. If Diana want, if people want to see Diana, you know, sooner than I'm planning on playing her, then of course I'll do it. But you know, that's the sixth code was intended to be mine for my Steam playthrough if I wanted to do it on Steam. But I'm just doing it, playing the game off my hard drive. So I'm just going to give you guys the code if I'm allowed to do that. But in any case, big shout out to you guys. Big shout out to Michaela Laws. First and foremost to you guys, because, you know, all of you guys are absolutely awesome. I mean, many of you have come from, you know, come to my channel for Seduce Me. You found me because of Seduce Me, and you have actually branched out and watched my other videos. And for that, I'm eternally grateful. You guys are absolutely awesome. And I can't even express my gratitude for that. This is one of the only ways that I can physically express it without just saying thank you. And again, big shout out to Michaela Laws for not only making a wonderful game, but providing this opportunity for you guys. Such a nice woman. And a great, great game developer, and just an overall amazing person. I mean, let's just be honest. So with that being said, again, huge shout outs to all you guys. Let's go ahead and give you guys your reward for being awesome. Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1, good luck. All right, what's under the hat is going to be the second winner of the Seduce Me 2 giveaway. Again, don't worry. There's 3 more codes, potentially 4, okay? I'm pretty sure I'll be allowed to do that. But in any case, again, I'll be bringing you guys more codes. There are still more codes to go. From here until the end of the giveaway, you guys are going to have so many, the end of the whole series as a whole, after all the playthroughs and everything, you guys are going to have so many chances to enter. So don't worry, there's plenty of opportunities left. 219 entries, guys. Come on, that is absolutely insane. That's actually more than my Crusaders series right now, because I did a list wipe to kind of clear away the names of the people that I knew weren't watching. But I know all of you guys are watching. I mean, all of you guys that are in here multiple times, I mean, I'm pretty sure every single person in here is in multiple times. All right, guys, and that's going to wrap up this Seduce Me 2 giveaway. Okay, again, we have 3 or 4 codes left. In pertinence to what's under the hat, again, congratulations. Make sure you drop your comment down below so I can, you know, verify that you're accepting the code, and so that people can congratulate you and whatnot. And of course, I'll be sending that code to you through your YouTube private message system. Make sure you have that all squared away in your Google Plus settings. And that goes for everybody. Make sure you do that in case you do win. And also, I'll get you guys your code one way or the other. Don't worry. It doesn't have to be through YouTube. It's just the easiest way. If we have problems, I'll get it to you through either Twitter or Facebook or your Steam messaging system, or any way that I can get you your code. You'll still get it regardless. But it's just easier if you have your YouTube private message system enabled so that I can just message you right away once I realize that you've claimed your code in the comments down below of this video. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll see you back in the game. Sam nodded before taking my hand and rushing forward, speeding through the twists and turns of the castle towards a large archway leading up into the tower, where we could hear Diana and the Demon Lord fighting above. Sam and I raced up the stairs of the tower, hearing the echoed cries and clashes of steel bouncing off the stone walls. My heart began to race as the sound of weapons meeting stopped with Diana screaming, "No! Dude! Gross. Holy, this is an awesome final battle room." Sam and I finally reached the top, staring wide-eyed at the sight of the Demon Lord and Diana. The Demon Lord had Diana's throat in a hard grip as his other hand gripped onto her wings, his fingers digging into them roughly. We could barely react as the Demon Lord ripped them off of Diana's back by pulling Diana's body in the opposite direction. Damn! Oh my god. Gross! Why do we gotta hear that? I'm pretty sure I heard like tendons and shit. That's disgusting. The Demon Lord, basking in his success, lifted the torn wings to his mouth and let the blood dribble from the open wounds onto his tongue? Fabulous. I fought not to gag at the sight. That's fucking gross. Sam, however, shouted and made the room shake with his voice. His rage showed his feelings clearly, despite seeing the one who fathered him after years of separation.
Hey, shithead!
Oh, damn. The Demon Lord instantly peered over, locking his eyes onto Sam's form as Sam began to step forward. Appeased with the new challenger, the Demon Lord licked his lips and tossed Diana to the side. Diana landed with a hard thud and slid across the floor, slamming against one of the stone frames that kept the stained glass of the room together. On her back were 2 large open wounds that weren't healing or fading away into her body like I expected. Diana!
Go check on her. This bastard is mine.
Jesus, dude. Sam continued to walk forward as I nodded and rushed over to Diana. She struggled to push herself up onto her hands, falling back onto the floor in failure as I approached. I got you, hold on. Sarah, hurry up, don't worry. Where are you at? He's never here when the battle's taking place. Oh, before my eyes, a small white light flashed beside us, revealing Sarah. He quickly looked around before he looked down at Diana and rushed to his knees beside her. Oh no. I got onto my knees and helped Diana get up onto hers, seeing her worn and tired face. As she got up, she instantly fell to the side in Sarah's arms. Sarah quickly wrapped his arms around Diana and kissed her head, most likely trying to feed her energy to heal. Her back wounds, despite the energy, were still not closing. All across her body were slash marks and bruises from the intense struggle, but I knew already that she had put up a good fight. Now it was Sam's turn, and she... I'm hoping, you know, it made him expend a lot of energy in the process, because we had to fight Malix, which took a little bit of the energy, I'm assuming, and then, you know, there was a pretty intense battle, and I hope she did enough, and I hope Sarah just doesn't, like, actually helps us. seriously. The Demon Lord raised his arms to his sides, visually challenging his new opponent with a wide smirk on his face and a scowl in his eyes.
So you want to die too? I always knew you were a disgrace.
Oh, shit.
I've waited a long time to kick your ass.
Whoa. That is... Hold the phone. Hold the phone with this. Well now. That's crazy. Sam glared hard at the Demon Lord before reaching up and summoning his sword. As he did, flames began to quickly engulf his body, twisting and... Oh, he's letting loose now. Twisting and shaping into multiple dragons that brought surprise and fear into the Demon Lord's eyes. He's scared. This dude's like, what the heck is this? Say, Demon Lord, however, snarled and summoned his own blade, ready to battle. There was no more room to place threats. Their blades would speak for them now. Sam and the Demon Lord rushed at each other, arching their blades at each other and slamming their swords together. As they clashed, red lightning and wildfire shot out from the impact between them. This did not deter Sam and the Demon Lord from slashing and swinging again at each other, parrying over and over with murderous vigor. It was like watching fireworks go off in a massive storm. The flames around Sam began to circle around him and the Demon Lord, forming an inescapable ring around them. This was going to be a battle to the death, by flame or by sword. Neither opponent seemed to hold anything back.
How did you get this power?
I don't know, man. Frickin', he did something to a dragon.
Doesn't matter how! All you need to know is that I'm gonna use it to kill you!
Say. The Demon Lord grabbed hold of Sam's sword and kicked Sam's hand to make him release it. However, as the sword left Sam's hand, it vanished and reappeared in Sam's grip. Dude, he's Harry Houdini. As if it belonged there. What? It better not just, like, not be able to leave your hand during sex and stuff. That's going to be quite difficult. Using the opportunity, Sam slashed the Demon Lord and carved a deep line into the Demon Lord's chest. Oh, get wrecked. Hey. The Demon Lord stepped back, gripping his chest, as before my eyes, the skin around the wound began to burn and release black smoke. Are you shitting me? This is cool, man. I'm loving this. The Demon Lord snarled in reply, swinging his sword again at Sam.
You're dead.
Have fun with it. The Demon Lord pummeled a barrage of slashes and swipes at Sam with his sword, only to be blocked and parried each time. I felt a hopeful smile grow on my face. We were gonna win. The strange excitement of the situation filled my body with joy. I was going to go home and be with my family and my friends and live in the human world. Sam and I were going to live happily ever after, and this was the door to get us there. Stop thinking. Don't stop. You're going to jinx it, dude. We're going to go home. See, this is, and then that's going to get fucked. Watch this. Sam and the, I hope not, but I'm just assuming. Sam and the Demon Lord jumped away from each other, glaring hard at one another as they began to circle each other. No, don't listen to him, Ivo. Don't, Sam, you're gonna, oh my god, dude. I have a feeling Sam's gonna listen to him.
You don't fucking get it, do you? I don't just have the power of a dragon.
My eyes couldn't believe what I was seeing. A pair of wings wreathed in flame and erupted from Sam's back, lifting him into the air. Sam's voice boomed through the air, filling with magic rage and power.
I am a dragon!
No! We slept with a dragon! Oh, come on, don't even tell me that... The dragon's inside of this dude. Sam raised his sword, causing it to become engulfed by red and green flame, before swinging it down onto the Demon Lord. As it clashed with the Demon Lord's sword, a burst of flame erupted from between the blades. Say, each Each block the Demon Lord had caused another and another burst to explode in his sight. Sparks and flame licked violently against his skin as he tried to defend himself from the dragon that was Sam. Soon enough, even the Demon Lord couldn't defend anymore. Sam knocked the Demon Lord's sword away, causing it to slide against the floor outside of the ring of fire.
No!
my sword!
It's over!
Oh man, have fun with it, you're gone. Sam swooped at the Demon Lord and jammed his blade into the Demon Lord's chest, making his resounding gasp of pain echo through the flames. The Demon Lord's eyes wavered, staring at the far walls. The flames around them began to die out. Black and red smoke rose from the table, or I'm sorry, rose from the blade, dancing around the Demon Lord's body and dissipating into the air above. Peace, dude.
Goodbye, old man.
That was ridiculous. I'm not even gonna lie. I hope that's it, because that was insane. Sam gripped his sword with both hands and yanked the sword out from his father's body, making the Demon Lord arch back before falling forward. Smoke continued to rise and engulf the Demon Lord's body as if it was beginning to cremate itself after death. Damn. As the Demon Lord let out his last breath, silence at last engulfed the room, only interrupted by the sound of Sam's labored breathing. It was over. It was finally over. I could feel tears well up in my eyes as the situation sank into my body, causing me to place my hands on the floor and stare into the dark marble. We did it. We really did it. I looked to Sam, seeing him land softly on the ground while his wings vanished into clouds of smoke. As he turned to me, I could see exhaustion hit his body like a tidal wave. One step towards me brought him crashing down to his knees.
Sam!
Before I could even stand to run to him, Sam lifted his hand, laughing tiredly.
I'm fine. Calm down.
I relaxed for the moment, relieved to know that he was all right. I felt myself let out a sigh as I heard Diana chuckle beside me.
He wore you out that fast? You're not as tough as you look, brute.
Are you kidding? Did you see the flames? I mean, we were a dragon for a second. I'm sure, like, if we really were a dragon, like, I'm assuming that was a literal sense, we must have become hella heavy. That's not easy to keep up with, okay? Sam chuckled and, I mean, he did. Not easy for him to do. Sam chuckled and raised a middle finger at Diana, curling his shoulders over himself as he tried to breathe and relax from the whole ordeal. I felt myself laugh as I took in the situation as well. The war was over. It was, come on, why you gotta stop jinxing it?
I won't be the only one who dies here.
Are you serious? Weren't you supposed to be, like, crispy by now? His whispered voice barely reached my ears. It couldn't be. I looked over, horrified, as I saw the Demon Lord barely pushing up on his hands, glaring at me through the smoke surrounding him with crazed, almost psychotic eyes. As he suddenly pointed his hand at me, everyone else had only just turned around to see him.
Die!
No, not the special beam cannon to my face. I'm dead? Within a mere breath of a second, a line of red lightning was fired straight at me from his outstretched hand. I didn't have time to react. I didn't have time to think. Time seemed to move in slow motion as the red bolt inched closer to my body, about to make impact with my sternum. Sam, despite his speed, wasn't fast enough to stop its journey toward my chest.
No!
I could see my life flash before my eyes. It was over. I...
No!
Diana! I felt my body being pushed violently to the side, away from the incoming attack. I turned my head as I was pushed and stared wide-eyed at who was pushing me away. Diana? Wait, who the fuck? With a crash, the window behind us shattered with Diana flying out of it. Dude! Come on, man! Couldn't you have thrown your wing in front of it or something? Diana, who had been beside me the entire fight, stared at the incoming attack as she took my place in its trajectory. There was no time to shout back. There wasn't any time to stop it from happening. I could only watch as the ray slammed against Diana's chest and forced her body backwards into the stained glass behind us. My gaze followed Diana's body, seeing her look to me with a sad, teary-eyed smile. There were no words that could be said as she flew into the air. There was no way to grab her and pull her back.
No, not into the sea, my dude! I just remembered that. All I could do was watch as Diana's body arched back and plummeted downwards towards the decaying sea. Fuck!
She no longer had her wings.
Fuck!
So she couldn't fly to save herself. Sero!
Any creature unfortunate enough to fall into that cursed stretch of water will be doomed to sink into an endless black.
I know, you don't have to remind me. I'm shitting the bed.
Die due to the dark magic in the water, but they can never come back up. There is no saving them.
We need a rope. Straight up, man. No! I reached out, despite the futility of it, towards Diana and watched her sink through the air as gravity took hold. I barely had time to blink as a figure ran past my body and pushed off the ledge of the window, zipping straight toward it. Saro, dude, you gotta make this catch. This is clutch, man. This is clutch right here. You make this. Isaiah! Oh shit, you're going in too? Saro, face pale as snow, had projected his body towards her and had managed to wrap his arms around her form, causing her to cling to him. Both demons, however, plummeted down towards the dark waters, quickly vanishing from sight. What? Both demons? You're an angel, don't you have wings? Spread them shits, man. I couldn't even see the splash their bodies made as they hit the water surface. Diana! I gripped the edge of the tower, not believing what I was seeing. This couldn't have been real. Diana and Saro were gone? Even as Saro called her name, even his magic was on their side. How could they be gone? The garbled noise from the Demon Lord's throat being impaled barely caused me to turn and see Sam ram his sword through his father's neck. At last, the Demon Lord fell, lifeless for sure. However, my vision became obscured by tears. Why didn't you do that in the first place, my dude? Seriously, man. Like, isn't that, like, commonplace? Don't you, like, I mean, I'm not one to know. Like, I didn't grow up in those times or anything. But, I mean, when that happens, I mean, they're kind of like a mix between magic and like, the Middle Ages or the Dark Ages. When someone like that is taken over, don't you behead them anyway? Man, follow your customs, bro. It could have all been avoided. One more sword slash and it would have been over. Damn. I watched behind a veil of tears as Sam rushed over to me and wrapped his arms around me, pulling me close and laying my head on his shoulder.
Are you okay?
No. No! What the? I could barely even utter a no or shake my head. I buried my face into Sam's shoulder, gripping to him as the sight of Diana falling burned itself into my memory. I felt something in my soul lift and disappear, but I couldn't have cared less. I heard the heavy sounds of footsteps rush toward us, but I didn't lift my head up.
Sam!
Wait, you felt something in your soul lift and disappear? Holy, that's not good.
Wait, where's...
That's worse than your heart swelling up, dude.
Diana and Saro were gone.
Get a rope, people! Oh my god. I mean, you know where they... Look where they fell, and, you know, shit, get a rope.
God.
Fifth line.
They fell into the sea.
Stop acting so calm. Use that thing. Roll it up. I felt Sam nod, still hugging me tightly. He held my head close to him as he spoke for us.
Diana saved her from that bastard's last attack. The guard jumped after her.
Jeez, man. That's how you know his love was real. Like, he didn't give a shit. He just didn't think, he just went. A sad silence engulfed the room. What could have been said? The Demon Lord was defeated, but the rebellion had lost its queen. For a moment, the world felt dark and cold, as if the war had been lost alongside Diana despite the rebellion obtaining victory. I gripped onto Sam, feeling deep sadness for the entire situation. Diana saved my life, sheltered me, and fell into a seemingly endless sea because of me. Sam, feeling my anguish, tightened his embrace around me and let me bury my face in his chest. The war had ended at last, but now we didn't know where to go. At least that's what I thought. Sam gently loosened his embrace around me and looked to the remaining rebel demons with a hard gaze. I looked up, wiping my eyes in confusion. What was wrong now?
Will you all honor her words?
Her words? Wait, she gave it to you?
Well, she wasn't giving it to you. What? There was more? What did Sam mean? Faye looked to her companions as they stared at Sam in shock.
Well, we don't have much of a choice, do we?
We can't exactly refuse the Lord of Dragons.
I looked up at Sam, feeling completely lost. Sam looked down at me and helped me stand before releasing my body and stepping away from me. With a sigh, he looked down to the floor. Sam?
Diana made me promise something. If she died, then...
You're gonna have to stay here and be the person? Then? Sam looked to his brothers in nervousness. I looked over as well to see them confused, but ushering him to continue before turning back to Sam and holding his hands. Then what?
If she died, then I'd step in for the rebellion and take the throne.
Jeez, man. I stared wide-eyed at Sam. What? Sam was now the leader of the rebellion? What of the others?
I look to the other rebel leaders to see them bow their head to Sam, answering my mental question and causing me to look back at my fiancé. What about us? Would Sam leave me? Would he make me stay? Did that make me a queen? Did that mean I had to stay no matter what? We had to stay? Stop asking questions, let him finish. What about the human world? Sam, most likely feeling my nervousness in my hands, grasped them and gently pulled me to him.
Look, I made a promise to her, but I'm yours first. If taking the throne means leaving you, then I'd rather burn it.
What? We're gonna have to make the choice?
Hey!
What? Sam. His eyes burned into my gaze, showing me his utter devotion. He was serious about needing to take it. But I knew that he would never leave me or force me away from him. Sam gently rubbed my hands with his thumbs and stared down at them.
So, I'm leaving the choice up to you. The Demon Lord's dead, so we can go back and live normal lives and whatever in the human world.
Or we can stay and rule the demon world? Sam nodded, affirming my assumption. It was a lot to take in. I wasn't sure how to respond. The dream of me looking back to see my family and friends began to haunt me. If I stayed, I would never be able to see them again. Why? What? There's spells. There were spells. Like, literally, there's spells to go back and forth. We can visit every once in a while. I mean, Diana, you know, did that thing with the shadow, and then they put all the ingredients together and opened up a void to my room. Those are two ways right there. What do you mean? You'd never be able to see them again. Shit. More than that, would the demon world even accept a human queen? Would I have to become a demon or something? Sam nodded as Shadow stepped up.
Naturally, demons would never accept a human as their ruler. Besides, while it is impossible for a demon to be separated from their magic and become human, the same isn't the case the other way around.
I'm not digging this.
We'd be able to turn you into a succubus, a demon of Lilith, as they were originally formed from a being who was once human before.
I don't like this. I don't. So I would be a succubus if I stayed? But I'd be ripping myself away from my family, my friends. Was it fair to them? Was it fair to me? What about my family and friends? Sam lowered his head as James stepped forward.
If you decide to stay, then we would be tasked with asking angels to remove any memories of you from the human world.
I don't like this! This is just negative thing after negative thing! No! What? Dude! Can't one of you... I mean, seriously, James frickin'... I don't know how good of a king Damien would be, but frickin' Eric, I mean... The other kid... Matthew, someone throw a rope. I mean, seriously, get them out of there, man. Shit. The dude's an angel. He should be able to haul himself out of there, man. My heart drops. My parents, my friends, anyone who knew me would forget. Wait.
If you decide to stay, then we would be tasked with asking angels to remove any memories of you from the human world.
That's even worse. I thought it was just me. So I'm gonna know and they won't? Are you shitting me? My parents, my friends, anyone who knew me would forget. It would be for the best, but to think that I would no longer exist for them made my eyes water slightly. Dude! I wasn't sure what to say. I felt myself freeze in place, unsure whether to run back into the light of the human world or to stay in the dark of the demon world. I could feel the situation sink hard into my stomach, but I knew I had to make a choice. Thoughts of Diana pushing me away from the Demon Lord's final attack replayed in my head, reminding me that she gave her life for me when she was meant to take up the responsibility of having the world on her shoulders. Sam gripped my hand tightly, causing me to gaze up into his eyes.
I know this is a big decision, but just know that whatever you choose, I'll be with you no matter what.
Dude. I stared up at him, seeing an endless world of love buried within his emerald irises. He would put me first no matter what. But what would I choose? My family and friends were important to me, but this world became important too. I closed my eyes, remembering my grandfather's words. You should do what makes you happy. I opened my eyes and smiled at Sam, my heart finally reaching a decision. I want to save. All right, let's go about this logically, okay? Because I'm honestly, me personally, I would want to go back to the human world. I would say screw this, because even though I know that she made him promise that, but there's no reason why any of the freaking, you know, guard, like, all these people, the generals, right? There's no reason the generals can't take over. There's no reason any of the other brothers can't take over, because what are they doing? You know, we don't know what they do. They could be in the demon world for all we know. We could throw a rope down. Okay, so beyond all that, right? Beyond all of that, the fact that we could actually do a lot of other things, this isn't, in my mind, I know it's the only choice the game is giving us, but it's not the only choice to me. I think there's a lot of other possibilities here. You know what? I'm going to do both. I want to see how both endings work. But for the record, so you guys know what I would have chosen, despite the fact that I probably would have, in my heart, I probably would have always regretted it. Not really regretted it because I thought it was the wrong decision, but just because of the fact that I would have always felt bad for choosing it, but I would have went back to the human world, 100%. But I would not have stayed here, for sure. But I would have been sad. I would have been upset probably my whole life that I didn't do that. But I don't think that, first of all, I don't think it's our responsibility, and I don't think that we'd be up to that responsibility. I think there's many more people that would be qualified. And it just doesn't rely to us. Just because she made us promise, it's like the only thing tying us to having this obligation is the fact that he promised to her that he would do this. And he should have consulted me about it. You know, you can't just do that. But yeah, you guys get my point. So yeah, I would return to the human world. So we're going to do that route first, and then we're going to see what happens if we stay in the demon world and all that stuff. So I did save, right? Yeah, okay. So for the record, I'll choose what I was going to do first, so you guys don't think I'm just being neutral because I don't want to make a decision. My heart belonged there. I was human after all. I knew that the demon world was important to Sam and Diana, but I would have never been truly happy there. I missed the blue sky, and the sweet air of home called me back. And you know, I wouldn't want to, like, have nobody, you know, remember me, I guess. I don't know. Like, I mean, that doesn't really matter to me, but it's like, it would have been really sad knowing that I was the only one. I know I have family back home, but they don't even remember me. You know what I mean? That would be a really sad thing. That's like a really depressing thing. And like I said, like she's saying, I don't think she would be happy. Like that would make me really sad. You know what I'm saying? I would never be able to leave the people that I care about. The curse on me had been lifted. We fought in the war to return home. That was what we had to do. Sam smiled slightly and nodded. The incubi and the wives smiled as well. But the rebel leaders lowered their heads and looked at each other in concern. Dude, you got this. What? I mean, shit. Faye, you were bitching a second ago. I quickly turned to them, not wanting to leave them without a plan. We worked together to rebuild this world. Diana would have wanted that from all of you. Yeah, it wasn't the whole war fought so that there couldn't be another dictatorship? I mean, I know Diana wouldn't have been a dick like this, like the Demon Lord, but I mean, that's the whole, you know, war was fought for equality and for everyone to work together, not be separated and in, you know, a shitty situation. A lump in my throat almost blocked me from finishing that sentence. It was deeply painful to refer to Diana as dead, as she gave her life for me. But the world needed a leader, and it had four. The four rebel leaders looked to each other and nodded.
We will do our best. Thank you for trusting the world with us.
You got it. See? It's working out. I'm telling you, this is what it should... I don't see why this was a big deal. This is what it should have been like.
What are we gonna do first? We could do all kinds of really amazing things. Like rebuild the forest. No! Wait! Have a party! Wait! No!
See? She's got a lot of great ideas. This is great. It's working. It's working out fantastic. Throw a party first. That's what I would do.
Say, quiet.
Damn. Get shut down.
Oh, lighten up. The war is over. We have a reason to celebrate.
I smiled, happy to know that the world was in good hands. See, I think so. Personally, I really do. However, Faye took a breath and looked to me with a small smile before forming a small lavender-colored lily in her hands.
Before you go, though, since Diana is, well, she wanted to give you this.
I stared at the flower in surprise. What was it? I reached out and took it into my hands, practically feeling magic and energy run through it. It's lovely.
The flower of Lilith. But how can that be?
They were said to have died out generations ago.
I continued to stare at the flower, entranced by its spell. It was such a gorgeous-looking flower, I could barely tear my eyes away.
Put it behind your ear. I think she said it was magical or something.
Everything in this world is magical. The shit that comes out of your butt is probably magical. Shit. I tilted my head before nodding and lifting it to tuck it behind my ear. As it settled against my ear, I felt mist circle my head and form into a flower crown of lavender lilies. The way everyone looked at me made me feel like I was in my bridal wear already.
Whoa. Amazing!
I looked to Sam, seeing him grin from ear to ear at the sight of me. I blushed, feeling somehow timid with the flower crown on my head, but happy to know that it had rendered my husband speechless. However, as I lifted my hand to the flowers, feeling their soft petals, I could feel the world fade to a white color. No! Huh? From the direction of where Diana had fallen, a figure stepped towards me, bathing in light. I covered my eyes with my arm for a moment before seeing who it was. Diana? Wait, we fell in? With a smile, Diana stepped in front of me and gently ran her hand along the crown over the petals of the flowers. I stared wide-eyed at Diana, unbelieving that I was seeing her.
I expected you to choose the human world. Really, dear. So predictable.
Diana. Diana chuckled, stopping me from whatever I was planning on saying, before cupping my chin to make me gaze into her eyes.
Well then, promise me that you will take care of the brute. He needs a strong woman guiding him. And you've been blessed by the flowers of Lilith. So it seems you're up to the task.
I felt tears form and drip down my cheeks, but I nodded. Something in my heart lifted and I felt at ease with everything. I had made the right choice. With a smile, Diana tilted forward and kissed my forehead beneath the crown before stepping away.
May you be happy with your choice, dear. And thank you.
Diana slowly turned and began to walk away further into the light of the area. Sarah, who was also bathing in light, slowly appeared and waited for Diana with an arm out for her. Diana took his hand and smiled up at him before looking back to me, nodding and walking away. As they both vanished into the light, the world around me reappeared, with everyone staring at me in shock.
Whoa, hey. Are you all right?
What? I quickly looked at Sam before lifting my hand to my cheek, feeling the trails my rogue tears left behind over my skin. I wiped my eyes and cheeks before nodding, laughing softly. I'm fine, sorry. I smiled brightly, taking in a breath, and looking up at Sam while taking his hands. Let's go home. Home. Ew. She got a stutter.
You both went through a dragon's trial to be together. A dragon's trial.
Ew, dude. Like, we have a really hard time understanding.
Word spread far and wide about the rebellion's success, and soon every kingdom in the Abyssal Plains had become united with the new authority.
See? It didn't turn out so bad. Yes, Sam wasn't the one to lead, but you know what? It seems to have worked out phenomenally, as far as I'm concerned.
You would think demons would be more hostile towards each other, being demons and all, but the threat of the demon lord was what brought the entire world together. When Diana's body was found, the entire rebellion wept. Even the rebel leaders, and especially Sero. Despite the war being over and celebrations being the highlight of the night following it, the death of their queen became the dreadful morning news.
I am so confused. Hold the phone! When Diana's body was found, they said they don't die. So if Diana's body is found, hooray, you found her! Like, and then even the rebel leaders, and especially Sero, he jumped in with her. What is this?
She was given a public cremation, watched by the entire rebellion army, and when her body became ashes, Sero took the remains to a tree sacred to her family, burying her ashes at the roots.
Are you lying to me? Are you lying? You're lying to me. Like, this is a false story. You're telling me this to make me feel better. I'm done. Like, what's going on?
What did Sero do then? Well, you see, since he's half angel, his angel blood prevents him from letting him take his own life, as it's inscribed on their blood by heaven, that they will live until time or their enemies end them. None of the rebel leaders would agree to take his life, and every demon in the Abyssal Plains came to respect him too much to challenge him. So he simply sits at the foot of Diana's family tree, desperate to wither away.
Someone crossed this dude off! Like, first of all, holy shit, he's alive, first of all? And Diana's body was found and it was dead, and she's dead? Like, what? And now he's just sitting under a tree? What is this? What is this, dude? Sam, help this oh my god, I'm floored.
I think he's still there now. Poor Cyril.
Well, make me feel like shit then. This is a fake story, I'm not believing you.
Anyway, the other rebel leaders, desperate to make sure that her death wouldn't be in vain, brought themselves together and swore to bring the world to the peace they believed she imagined it to have.
I'm so unsure of how all this stuff couldn't have been done. You know what I'm saying? Like, I really believe they could have been saved, first of all. And they found the body. Like, that literally means that they... And I was thinking to myself, okay, well, maybe, right, maybe if they were to pull the bodies up, they wouldn't be able to pull them past the surface of the water because of the magic. But that's not true, because they said they found the body. And Sarah was alive, well, and kicking. Like, he's doing great. So I'm really unsure of what's going on here, to be honest with you.
All of it in the memory of the fallen succubus.
Great job.
Since Diana and Cyril fell to their demise, and you decided to return to the human world with Sam, the rebel leaders took up the mantle together and vowed to bring peace and prosperity to the demon world.
I mean, that's phenomenal, but what is going on?
While it was a tough time for them, as a majority of the world still mourned the loss of the rebel queen, they managed to bring the world together and bring a steady peace to the demons within it. They worked diligently to this day, trying to bring equality to the entire world and create a world their queen would have been proud of. And I believe that is everything that happened after, well, except for your story anyway.
Literally, dude, either way it would have been sad, right? Either way, freaking Sarah, I mean, apparently, Sarah would have been depressed about this and upset, apparently. I thought he was dead, or under the sea, apparently, like freaking with Ariel swimming around and shit. And Diana would have died too, or under the sea, dancing with Ariel and shit, because that's what I thought was the case, man. Oh, I'm so confused. Someone explain this, because I'm about to pop.
Sam and you returned home and prepared to get married at last. No distractions. No kidnappings.
Phenomenal. And it's like, it's crazy because, you know, you would have, either way, like, that's what happens, whether we stayed or not. Like, that's still what happens, you know what I mean?
Huh? How do I know?
Yeah, you have your ways. But, so I'm going to see the other ending. I'm going to see the other ending and see what that's all about. See if it differs. Because if it's the same, you know, stuff, you know, I don't know what to say. Like, either way, we would have been feeling bad, right? We would have had no family, no friends, no nothing. We would have been in the demon world, and Diana would have been dead, and Sarah would have been depressed. It would have been terrible. Absolutely terrible. By the time I returned to the human world, I had regained all of my pre-wedding jitters. My mind began to furiously worry about the wedding again, all the way until it came time to walk down the aisle. After that, it was surprisingly smooth sailing. I would forever remember the moment the bells chimed and the taste of Sam's lips, gross, on mine as we were pronounced wife and husband. The ceremony erupted in cheers, and the reception carried that energy into the night. I could go on and on about the wedding and the honeymoon, but honestly, after the war, I was more concentrated on living my life afterwards. Our lives escalated to new heights after we officially became husband and wife. Sam began to climb the ladder of the public service chain and eventually became chief of police. Everyone at work respected him, even the criminals that came in after being arrested. As for me, I began to go through my own success in life, dedicating myself to becoming exactly what I wanted to be. After all, my husband was a cop who was also secretly a demon. If I put the same amount of work in as I did in the demon world, then I was going to be okay. However, there was never a day that went by that I didn't think about what was happening in the Abyssal Plains. It was a heavy chapter of my life, one that tested the love between me and Sam. To think that I was married to the Lord of Dragons, apparently it was a very powerful title to own, and I happened to be in love with the man who carried it. A title like that, I was sure, carried a large amount of responsibility. Still, I was confident that the world would get through it. That we would get through it and stay together no matter what came our way. Demon, devil, dragon, didn't matter to us. We were unstoppable together. The faint memory of my own power slightly tingled through me every time I grew confident, eagerly reminding me that I had strength of my own. I would never let anyone come between me and Sam ever again. Whoa! Standing over the stove, I took a moment to let my mind wander as the breakfast I was preparing slowly cooked. Sam was still passed out in bed, tired from working the day before, so I let him sleep peacefully. It was adorable remembering his sleeping face, a goofy grin, hair rustled and wild, expression surprisingly peaceful. I could only chuckle as I began to plate our food and arrange the breakfast tray to carry it all. The plates weren't a problem, but the glasses and jug of orange juice made it a challenge. I, however, was confident enough in my skills to carry breakfast to our room to surprise Sam. I hope you are, after fighting a war. Everything smells great. Let's hope it tastes good, too. I slowly made my way to the bedroom, climbing the stairs one step at a time. While it was usually true that you lose balance the slower you go when carrying something, I didn't want to just bolt up the stairs in the hope of getting everything there in one piece. As I finally arrived, I quietly slipped into the room. At the sight of the still sleeping Sam, I smiled and let out a silent sigh of relief before walking in and placing the tray of food on the nearby nightstand. The sight of Diana's lily caught my attention. It was in a beautiful vase Sam and I custom ordered, decorating the nightstand perfectly. Because of its magical nature, it was still alive and looked as freshly bloomed as the day I received it. Despite it being a bittersweet day, Sam and I cherished the lily and cared for it a lot. It was a physical memory of an important chapter in my life, and I felt blessed to have it still. I let out another sigh before walking around the bed and sitting in the spot I usually slept in before gently nudging Sam.
Sam, it's almost 10 a.m., come on.
When Sam didn't move, I simply chuckled. He was indeed a deep sleeper. I gently leaned in and kissed Sam's cheek, hoping to break the spell of sleep on him with true love's kiss. It's time to get up, Sam.
5 more minutes.
Now listen here, I made you these waffles, you're gonna get up and eat them, okay? Alright, I could only laugh before crawling further into the bed and sitting beside him. While breakfast was waiting, Sam deserved to sleep a bit longer. He had been working hard ever since his promotion, so it was no surprise to see him struggle to get up. I ruffled Sam's hair a bit, making him groan and push my hand off directly, but that only spurred me to laugh harder. As I did, Sam finally opened an eye and stared up at me in an exhausted haze evident in his gaze. I covered my mouth and giggled, a little apologetic for waking him up with my laughter.
Sorry, I'll be quiet.
Sam shook his head and yawned, stretching his arms up and shutting his eyes before opening them again and lazily looking up at me from his pillow.
Morning, doofus.
Morning, Sam. I made breakfast. Sam sniffed the air and turned his head to look at the tray before nodding and returning to his lazy pose on the bed.
It smells good. Bet it tastes even better.
While his armpit is up, he's like, smells good. yeah, I hope so. Sam gave me a toothy grin before gently pulling me down to lie beside him.
Whoa, Sam!
I was silenced by Sam nuzzling my shoulder and pulling me close to cuddle against my body. My face began to heat as I felt his warmth around me. I took the moment in before nodding and wrapping my arms around him, nuzzling his chest. Sam smiled and kissed my head, relaxing into the embrace. He felt perfect in my arms, and nothing could have been better than being held by him. It was like lying in paradise. Did you sleep okay?
Mm-hmm. You?
Yeah.
Our words became simple, but our embrace only intensified our love for each other. The bed became like a cloud, and the room almost lost its shape in my eyes as all I could do was focus on Sam.
I love you.
I fucking hope you. I hope I do after all that. Yeah, ew, hee hee. I love you too.
I mean it. I love you and care about you so much.
I looked up at Sam, seeing the love he spoke of burn brightly in his eyes as he locked his gaze with mine. I felt my heart beating wildly in my chest before leaning up and nuzzling my forehead to his with a peaceful and happy smile. And I, you, Sam, more than anyone will ever know. There was nothing more that needed to be said. Our feelings were simple, but powerful enough to move continents. Damn. Our love may have seemed plain at a glance, but within our hearts burned the flames of our devotion and passion for one another. I couldn't stop my smile from growing before leaning in and kissing Sam lovingly, feeling him kiss back with the same amount of love and passion I had. No matter what, we would always find each other. We would always wind up back in each other's arms, and we would fly through every obstacle in our way on the wings of love, of our love. And that was my perfect happily ever after. End. Just you and me. Oh, man. All right. Well, fantastic. Skip this, please. Because we have another ending to do. Okay? We have another ending to do right now. We're going to jump right into it. Okay? Stay in the demon world. We're going to see what happens. Now, personally, I really like the ending that I got. Again,
you know, I really would feel terrible if the choice of return to the human world was what resulted in Dinah's and Sarah's death, or, I don't know, weird reality, because I feel like there's two different things going on there that I'm not really picking up on. But, you know, I would have felt really bad if my choice resulted in that, but it doesn't. This is after that, okay? So either way, we have to deal with that choice. And I personally feel like the choice of returning to the human world, while it may seem selfish, I personally believe it's the right choice. Because again, the only thing really holding Sam to that obligation was the promise he made to Diana. And while keeping promises is important, I don't think that it was right of her to ask us, okay? Yes, it was obviously, you know, it was right for her to ask us to fight in the war and not die and do our best to take him out and, you know, really complete the war and bring everything to a close. But to continue on in the demon world after that, I think is a bit much. And I think there's other people that are more qualified. As you guys saw, all those guys working together, I believe works out really well. Now, we'll have to see this and I'll let you guys know what I like better at the end. I feel like as of right now, my choice of returning to the human world is kind of like a more complete, encompassed ending than the other one. But we're going to see what this one does. So this was Sam's home. This was the place Diana and the entire rebellion had fought to protect and save. My time here made this world precious to me, and I wanted to take care of it as Diana would have. My heart gave a gentle thump, letting me know that I had made the right decision. Again, that has been happening too often for it to be healthy. Sam smiled brightly and nodded. He really enjoys that, apparently. His brothers and their wives nodded, accepting my answer, but the rebel leaders lowered their heads in respect to me and Sam. I quickly turned to them and smiled, knowing that they needed to be there and help us rebuild the world we were left with. We hope all of you will help us rebuild this world. Diana would have wanted that. A lump in my throat almost blocked me from finishing it. Ready to lead it. The four rebel leaders looked to each other and nodded.
We'll do our best. Thank you for trusting us.
What are we going to do first?
I'm just going to skip through things we've seen already. I smiled, happy to know that the world was in good hands. Took a breath and smiled for a smile later. Okay. Lilies. It's lovely. He's questioning it. They died, but they obviously didn't. And it freaking makes it into a head. He's surprised. Amazing. Awesome. White light. Huh? Diana's coming, right? Oh, hello.
I have to say.
Wait. With a smile, Diana stopped in front of me and gently ran her hand along the crown of over the petals of the flowers. I stared wide-eyed at Diana, unbelieving that I was seeing her.
I have to say, I'm shocked. But I'm very happy knowing my world is in good hands.
Diana. Diana chuckled, stopping me from whatever I was planning to say before.
Promise me that you will take care of the the king of the demon world. A king is no one without his queen. And in the demon world, the queen is the ultimate power.
Well, that's all fine and dandy. I felt tears form and drip down my cheeks, but I nodded. Something in my heart lifted and I fell at ease with everything. So either way, we're feeling good inside. All right, I made the right choice. It's the right choice either way. I love that. I love when choices are right. With a smile, Diana tilted forward and kissed my forehead. So she approves either way is what I'm liking here. I really enjoy that. That one way or the other, she doesn't disapprove. I feel kind of like I said before, I would always kind of feel like I should have chose the other thing. But in my heart, if I were in that scenario, I know that the right choice would have been to leave it to the people more qualified, leave it to the people that, you know, I feel would do a better job and are actually responsible for carrying on once the war is finished. Our responsibility ended and our obligation ended after the Demon Lord died and we brought peace to the demon world. As far as I believe, you know, we weren't, you know, just because we're together does not mean we have to rule the demon world. You know what I'm saying? But because of the fact that we were together, yes, it sparked the war quicker than it probably would have. Because as you know, I personally believe that it would have happened soon anyway, or it would have happened at some point anyway, you know, but you know, it happened sooner than it would have. And therefore we had an obligation to fight that war and help them because it was our fault. It's technically right. It's our fault. So, you know, that's as far as I think the responsibility should have gone. And again, I don't agree with this at all. I feel like they should have thrown a rope, okay? A rope or something. Or build a submarine. A magical submarine. I'm pretty sure you could have pulled that off.
May you be happy with your choice, dear. And thank you.
You're welcome. Freaking Sarah comes. Okay, everyone around me, they ask if I'm all right.
Oh, hey.
I'm good, yes. Cheeks, I'm fine. Taking a breath. All right, together.
Did you ever imagine that you'd end up being a queen?
No, I cannot say that I have.
That is so fantastic, though. Think about it. You are technically the second human to become a full-fledged demon and become royalty.
It's phenomenal. I'm more concerned about the fact that your shoulder looks absolutely dislocated, okay? That's
anyways,
what I'm worried about.
You've been through a lot, so why don't we skip, huh?
Skip. Yes, I want to hear. Thank you.
The entire rebellion celebrated. Word spread far and wide about the rebellion's success, and soon every kingdom in the abyssal plains had become united with the new authority.
Good.
You would think demons would be more hostile towards each other.
We know this already.
Because of the tragedy of Diana and Sero, you and Sam took up the throne of the entire demon world. You were transformed into a succubus and ruled at Sam's side.
Shit, all right then.
Many demons knew you were a human first, but didn't dare speak ill of you, since you were the queen and the wife of the fabled Lord of Dragons.
Yeah, exactly. You don't talk shit about the wife of the Lord of Dragons, okay? You just don't do such a thing. Plus, we're pretty badass on our own.
Huh? You don't know the legend? Well, it's an old tale, but to basically sum it up, when a demon has a pure heart, full of true strength and love, he will possess the power to conquer and consume the power of a dragon, making him the Lord of Dragons.
Phenomenal.
Man, guess you got lucky, huh? You're pretty much married to the strongest demon, not just in the demon world, but all five worlds.
Fantastic.
Anyways, you and Sam were able to bring the world together and bring about an everlasting peace. With the rebel leaders beside you to help you along the way, you both helped shape the world for a bright future. And I believe that is everything that happened after, well, except for your story and
anyway. Now, you know what? Now, I'm going to go through this too because I'm pretty sure it's going to be different. We're not going to be at the house and he's not going to be on the pillow. But, you know, what I want to, you know, it's kind of messed up that, like, in both cases, right? In both cases, Diana and Sero are dead, apparently, right? Or no, Sero's still alive. I don't really understand. It's weird, okay? You guys saw, I don't know if any of you guys saw, and maybe I wasn't perceiving it correctly, maybe I didn't read it right, but are you guys confused too? Because I'm hella just, I don't know. I'm stupefied right now. But, you know, it's funny how in the one where we don't choose the demon world, they make you feel kind of bad. Like, they make you feel really bad about choosing that. But again, this just kind of reaffirms it. Like, it would have happened either way. I'm sure all that stuff would have happened either way. Obviously, Sero is still good, you know, somehow. And, you know. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's still under that tree, like, crying. So, like, even though they didn't mention it here, it's still happening. So, it's just funny that they make you feel worse in the one where you choose the human world. But I really, truly believe that's the right choice. The only bad thing is, yes, you kind of feel a little bad because, you know, Diana did so much. You know, she saved our life and everything. And that's the part that makes me feel a little bad. But at the same time, even she in the dialogue did not expect us to choose the demon world. You know what I'm saying? So it's kind of good. Like, it doesn't matter. She was cool with it too. You know what I'm saying?
Since you rule the demon world now, how the demon world runs is entirely up to you. I'm sure Sam will happily walk along with you on your new adventure. After all, while demon marriage is entirely up to you, ruling an entire plane of existence is a whole new ball game. But I'm sure you can handle it. Huh? How do I know? Well, I'm pretty confident that you'll rock the queen thing. Take a look for yourself.
All right. To become a demon was an entirely new adventure for me. One I was very eager to go through. The ritual involved in turning me into a succubus involved candles and lilies and magic spinning through the air in threads of power. Being that I was a seemingly endless cask of energy, going through with the ritual was surprisingly easy to do. I was allowed to keep my memories of the human world, but my skin became etched with dark lavender markings. What really surprised everyone were my horns. Instead of having one on each side of my head, I had two. One on each side, curling around like ram's horns, and the second pair protruding up like mini bullhorns. Oh my god, that sounds extremely uncomfortable. Apparently, it was the mark of a truly powerful demon. I was very proud of myself for the accomplishment regardless. The wedding was even stranger, however. There were so many things involved that I could barely wrap my head around it, but the... It's funny, because now you have a lot of horns, so like, it would be hard to wrap things around your head. But the one thing I was able to remember was orbs forming in front of our chests at an ethereal green and lavender light connecting both. Was this the binding of souls? From that day on, I could almost sense whatever emotion Sam was feeling. I was able to find him anywhere and know that he was alright. It became a major asset as we became king and queen of the Abyssal Plains. It took me a long period to get used to the feeling of being royalty. I had responsibilities, duties as the matriarch of an entire world, and it frightened me beyond anything. However, the touch of Sam's hand in mine always managed to dissolve my fears. However, there was never a day that went by I didn't think about what had happened before I became a demon. It was a heavy chapter of my life, one that tested the love between me and Sam. To think that I was married to the Lord of Dragons, apparently it was very powerful, so I was confident that we would get through it and stay together no matter what came our way. The memory of your power, I mean, you have it. It's like literally there. The role of queen quickly became one of stress and moral questioning. There were always 10 or 20 issues every day to deal with, dozens more to look into, and hundreds more still to simply hear about. Oops. The guest room I was once human in became an escape from my duties. While the bed Sam and I shared in our master bedroom was obnoxiously large, I felt more comfortable in the peace of the smaller bedroom I had once claimed for a week. There were even times I would glamour myself human once more and simply sleep. Since demons didn't sleep, I was constantly working, but it was nice on the rare occasion to shut my eyes and let myself become lost in a dream world once more. That sounds depressing. You know what I mean? Sometimes Sam would join me. It was adorable remembering his sleeping face, a goofy grin, hair ruffled and wild, all in one piece, all in all peaceful. As much as we were perfectly fine being demons, it became a treat to indulge in the feeling of having human horns. I'm sorry, of having human forms, especially not having horns to adjust for when lying down. Despite the danger of being closing one's eyes in the demon world, I was confident that we were safe. I let the memories of my past flutter around in my mind as I lay in bed, slowly easing myself from the dream world and back into reality. When my eyes fluttered open, I could only smile at the sight beside me. Remaining in my human form just a while longer, I slowly sat up and stared at the sleeping Lord of Dragons, feeling waves of contentment and joy rush through me at the sight. As my eyes traveled up, I took notice of the lily on the nightstand. It was Diana's lily, and it was the only fresh decoration in the room. In remembrance of the past, it was in a beautiful vase created by a demon craftsman, decorating the nightstand perfectly. Because of its magical nature, it was still alive and looked as freshly bloomed. Despite it being a bittersweet, I let it another sigh before gently nudging Sam. It's almost noon, come on, get up. Sam didn't move. She kissed the cheek. It's time to get up. 5 minutes. So the background's just different. It's the same thing. The background's just different. Oh, man. All right, guys. So basically, it was the same. The ending was the exact same. Some words were slightly altered. Like, they were talking about duties and everything, because they're obviously king and queen. They said, well, we'll do our duties later. We're going to lay here for a bit longer. But it was basically the same ending, just a different backdrop. So I did say I was going to give you guys my opinion on which one I personally liked better. And again, I still do like my original choice. I feel like it wraps everything up the way it's supposed to be wrapped up. At least in my opinion. You guys, of course, have different opinions, maybe. But I just feel like we're not meant for that. We're not meant for the demon world. We were meant to be there for what our responsibilities entailed. And once we were done, it was right for us to leave. It's not our place. It's not our, you know, we're not meant to be there. You know what I'm saying? Sam is, of course, but he even said he didn't like the demon world. He hated it, right? Or who was that? No, that was Damien, right? But either way, Sam, I'm sure, didn't like it either. But in any case, you know, I think it turned out good. You know, all the demons, instead of us being king and queen, the generals ruled, which seemed to turn out phenomenally. You know, and we got to go home. Nothing that like shouldn't have happened. You know what I'm saying? Like, we still got to keep our life. They got to keep their lives. We affected the fate of the demon world and made it into a better place. And I think that's what matters. And that's why I like my choice of going back to the human world. So let me know what you would have chosen or did choose in the comments down below. I'd love to hear it. Let me know what you think about my choice. Was there a way to save Diana? Because, you know, it didn't seem like it. I mean, I really don't know if there was a way to do it.
Again, our choice that we made at the end was after they had both, you know, basically, I guess, died or went into the ocean. I'm not really sure. There was a lot of confusion surrounding that. So whatever happened to them, right? They basically are together, right? As far as I know, anyway. So I'm really kind of confused of what's going on with all that. But in any case, you know, Dinah and Sero, they're together. And I guess that's technically what you guys meant. I guess you can technically say that's what happened. But is there another way to save them? Because I'd like to see that as well. For those of you that are wondering, I will be going back, probably once the series has completely ended, and checking into all of the different small routes that I didn't take. In the comments down below of this video, make sure, I'm going to be tallying up the previous videos too, so don't worry, but make sure you drop in the comments down below, who do you want me to do next? Because I've had pretty much the same amount of Eric, Matthew, and Damien. No, Damien was a little bit less, and I've had some for Diana too. Diana will probably be done last again, unless there's an overwhelming majority of people that want to see Diana's playthrough. But the actual order I intended to do it was James, who was first. Then I did Sam because it was very highly requested. And then I was actually planning to do Matthew after James, and then Eric, and then Damien, and then Diana. Because Matthew's storyline looks pretty interesting. I'm actually, now that I remember what Eric's storyline was, this one interests me heavily, okay? Completely forgot about that whole orb thing, but that's pretty cool. So I can't wait to get to that one, but I will keep good on my promise and do Matthew next, unless you guys have an overwhelming majority of wanting to see, I don't know, Damien for example. But yeah, it should be pretty cool. Let me know what you thought about the playthrough so far, what you thought about Sam's route, comments about it, all that stuff. I want to hear it all from you guys again. Hopefully, the winner of the giveaway does enjoy their prize. I know I gave it out towards the middle, so hopefully that was okay with you guys. But again, drop your comment down below if you want to enter the giveaway or re-enter the giveaway if you're re-entering. You do have to include that in some fashion in your comment. But aside from that, I mean, this was awesome. And it's crazy. We've only done two storylines so far. There's still four to go. And I personally, I'm loving that. I love there's so much replay value with the game. So with that being said, a big shout out to Michaela Laws, the developer of the game. That was phenomenal. Loved it. Huge, huge. That drew me in big time. Okay. It's very rare. I play a lot of games and I have over the course of time. And it's really rare for me to really get involved in a story. The last time that happened was Life is Strange, and that ended a long time ago. For those of you that, I did a whole playthrough on Life is Strange, you can check it out. I'll leave a playlist in the description for you guys, but in any case, that's the last time that happened. And I'm telling you, Life is Strange is my favorite storyline only game, okay? This comes very, very close to that, okay? Maybe even on par, but it's phenomenal. It really is. So big shout out to Michaela Laws. You know, awesome, literally awesome. The writing is phenomenal. Artwork is phenomenal. Everything. I don't have any complaints. All right, guys, with that being said, definitely make sure you rate the video what you think it deserved. If you did enjoy, please consider sharing the video as well. That kind of stuff really helps me out a lot, whether it's Facebook, Twitter, or any social media really, or even word of mouth with your friends. That's really awesome too. Of course, it directly helps me as well as the entire community, and it's greatly appreciated. So with that being said, if you want to become a sage in training, make sure you subscribe today. And as always, this has been Mr. Bazy, your favorite sage, and I'll see you in the next video.